Now, one of the interesting things which happened during the time, and actually was a side effect of all of this work, was the invention of negative staining. Now, this is a very remarkable technology, because what it did was it took electron microscopy out of the hands of the elite and gave it to the people, basically. Now, in those days, if you needed to do electron microscopy, you needed to have a professional electron microscopist. This is someone who knew how to shadow things with uranium. And he would evaporate uranium onto these objects and put them on the machine so that you could actually visualize them. Of course, electron microscope can see small things, but it needs contrast in order to see them. And this biological objects don't have enough contrast. You need some kind of heavier compound there with more electrons, that is. And so shadowing was part of the profession, and these electron microscopists had to be pampered. And if you were, say, working in the life sciences, you had to find a collaborator who, of course, exacted a very high price for this collaboration. And I started to work with someone called Bob Horne, who was a very interesting chap, was working with the electron microscope in the solid state physics group here in the Cavendish. And we had great difficulties in visualizing these things, and doing the shadowing, it was all terribly slow. So I decided, having come from a background of cytology, I would try and stain these. And so I knew you had to stain them with heavy metals. And so I got hold of phosphotungstic acid. The first thing I did is I measured its pH. And I discovered its pH was 3. So I said, I don't put biological objects into such acid conditions. So I neutralized it. And I took all these pieces of virus and I sprayed them onto this grid. And we took them over and we looked at them. Now, Bob Horne said, that's a mess. It's a total mess, everything. But then I saw something, and I knew immediately what it was. And I said, this is called negative staining. And how did I know this? Because in my medical course, I had learned to show how you'd look at treponema. Treponema is the agent, spirochaetes. Treponema is the agent that causes syphilis. And one of the things you diagnose is you put a drop on a slide and you put Indian ink in it. And you see the treponemas as white objects transmitting the light swimming in the sea of ink. And this is called negative staining. And this was invented in the 19th century for the optical microscope. And I understood that this was the exact image of this, but for the electron microscope. So with this, we could produce remarkable images, and it had two effects. One is it allowed at least the electron microscopy of small objects to go. But what happened is it took all the people working in virology and gave them a tool that they could all use, and really wiped out the profession of electron microscopists in a biological lab, because everybody could just do it. And of course, it's been a wonderful technique. It's been developed by many people. But it's again, I mean, in that sense, it's being able to say, this picture, I've seen something like this before, and of course, now I know. It's got to do with syphilis. Of course, you can't explain to someone that this is where venereal disease comes in. But it's effectively, it's the images that map onto each other.